Yesterday, the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee unanimously rejected the Constitutional Amendment Bill of 2017 that government had proposed to enable it compulsorily acquire private land. The legislators argued that the bill does not introduce anything new warranting an amendment to the Constitution, and in case of any need, amendments can be done in the Land Acquisition Act since they are most suited there.
Would like a civil society organizations dealing with land to commit that should the executive take this question to further consultation, because that's what was said, that it requires more consultation. We do think that as land actors we shall continue to engage and sensitize the public and advise them about the implications so that they can reject this amendment.
And we think this is an opportunity if the consultations are genuine and honest. Our call is that if consultations are going to take place on this amendment, they should be open and honest to get the voices of Ugandans.
Although the bill has been withdrawn from Parliament, the enjoyment of land rights still remain a great challenge to the country, with more complaints of people being displaced with little or no compensation. Civil society organizations have therefore made several demands, including government should continue to respect, uphold and promote Article 26 of the Constitution by undertaking informed consent of parties whose land it wishes to acquire. Parliament should amend the Land Acquisition Act to align it with the spirit and aspirations of Article 26 as recommended in the Sectorial Committee report to cater for the interests of landowners. Courts should handle land matters expeditiously as it is done with election petitions. Special courts to handle land disputes should be put in place, reform and strengthen land administration, address structural impediments that lead to delay of government projects, and also a need to revise the rates of valuation to suit market prices.
Article 26 is more progressive because it recognizes that government can acquire land. But what must it do before it takes possession of the land? It must pay the people. And the payment we are talking about has to be prompt, it has to be adequate.
They also advise that Parliament should take the matter before public for consultation, promising that they will hope to sensitize the public more about their land rights. This report was filed by Juliet Namuwaya for Urban TV.